I guess this is it. Last night under the waves. Need to call Emma. It's been too long already. All right, let's see what we can see.
Warning, extreme levels of stress detected. Downtime recommended.
Where is that? New York.
Do you need a break, Stanley Moray? A restful night makes for a productive day.
Running low. Tempting, but no.
Stan? This fucking signal on another one of Tim's bullshit. Stan! Stan, can you hear me?
I'm here. I'm here.
I saw the rig on the news. Worst platform accident in over a decade, they said. The environmental damage alone. And I can't even worry about that because my husband refuses to listen to reason.
I'm coming back.
All to chase some flight of... What?
I'm done. It's all done. I'm coming home. Tim's sending a boat. Tomorrow.
That's... okay. Okay, good. Why am I not... Why do I feel there's a but?
I just... I can't leave her like this. I think she needs my help.
Pearl.
Yes.
And... what does she say?
I don't expect you to understand.
Understand? What is there to understand when you're not making any sense? I'm pregnant.
What?
I'm pregnant, Stan.
Oh my God. Oh my. We're gonna have a...
a baby. We're gonna have a baby.
Oh my God. I can't. All right, look, I know I haven't been in a way I've just been. I just miss her so much, Emma. time I close my eyes, I see her, I see you, I see us, and it never stops hurting.
And you think it's been different for me? I haven't had a single waking moment of clarity in 3 years, but I knew I couldn't let that pain define me, or I would never, ever escape it. I love you, but starting again, moving on, it is hard, Stan. I'm gonna need you with me.
Today's fact of the day. She's never coming back, Stan.
Wait, what?
Today's fact of the day. She's never coming back, Stan.
Where is that? New York.
All right, last check-in. You'll pick up a ride around sunrise tomorrow and...
Emma's pregnant.
What?
Yeah.
Bugger me. Well, congratulations. How are you? How are you sitting with it?
Still... processing.
Ah, it's exactly what you need. It'll be perfect, I'm telling you.
What about you? What happens now?
That is a little more complicated. You know, maybe I'll go back to the boats. There's still a few decent crews out there. As for the data Unitrench tried to erase, well, you know how clumsy I can be. No telling whose mailbox it'll end up in.
I'll look forward to watching the fallout from a distance. Talk to you tomorrow. In person, this time.
Wouldn't miss it for the world. Sleep well, Stan.
The last The final. Never mind. Rest. I need rest.
To go somewhere. Lights are all green, ready to go.
Where are we going? Can't you speak to me? Where are we going? Where are we going? What do you want with me?
This is bad. Okay. Stay calm. Deep breaths. Conserve oxygen. She's gone. What the hell am I supposed to... Slide or something. If I can just push through here. Okay, let's see what we can see. Eyes forward. Eyes forward. Keep moving. System centered on a single being. Even in death, Emma told me their bodies, when they die, they release their gases, carbon dioxide, trapping it in the deep. What? What is this place? Okay, you. Think you've about worn out that armchair. Let's get out of here. When did you get so big, huh?
Up the wooden hill to Bedfordshire. Up the wooden hill to Bedfordshire.
Here we go.
Daddy. I had a good day.
Delivery. One sleepy girl. Better?
Better. It's cold.
Let me close the window. Under the covers now.
Okay, Daddy. Wait, where's Lumiere? Daddy, I can't find Lumiere.
Hey, hey, hey. He can't have gone that far. Not with those little legs of his. Don't worry, I'll find him. There you are. Been on quite the journey together, eh? Thanks for the ride. Found him. Think he was making a break for it.
Maybe he was trying to find you so you could tell us a story.
Okay. Okay, what'll it be?
The whale song.
Settle down. The whale song. Once upon a time, there was a baby whale. A cute calf, roughly 3 tons from head to tail. His mother was a different beast entirely, over 30 meters long. And 70 tons of love so motherly. The whale calf, not even close to her, worried without delay. Mummy, when you are gone, what will I become? Its mother would gently say, I will always be close to you. It was not a terrible lie to start, because our dead keep on living here, in our heart. But it wasn't fair for the baby whale, who had seen his father died from a harpoon's travail. He asked again, so where has Papa gone? His mother took a deep breath and replied, heads on. He is still here. His soul is swimming next to us, far and near. Then she added, I will bring you to a place without lies, a place without pretty sights. Always remember this, and you will move on. On the beach, where many corpses lie, whales in decomposition, skin dry, regurgitated balls of plastic for pillows. The calf's eyes got wet, and before long, tears flowed, warm and clear. His heart heavy, he started a song, sorrowful and sincere. From the baby's ache, out of the waves, a miracle happened. The air started to vibrate, the ground to shake. One of the still bodies rose,
and widened. Despite the waste and the rubbish, against the fragile cycle, death was ascending to the sky, across eternity's threshold. Then death would fall down to feed the earth, continuing a never-ending cycle in which we always find a morrow. Okay, love. Time for bed.
No, Daddy, please. It's still cold down here. And lonely. Stay. Please?
Oh, God. Sweetheart. I don't know if I can. Could I really stay? Emma. The baby. Pearl's here. She's right here. I can't just leave. Can I? Should I? Emma needs me. I need her. No, I have to stay. I won't lose my daughter. Not again. I'm sorry, sweetheart. Mommy needs me. We're having a... We need each other.
I love you, Daddy.
I miss you. I'll always miss you. Always.
My daughter died 3 years ago. Seems like hardly any time at all. And an eternity. It was her laugh that hurt most. Its absence. Like when she'd jump onto our bed on Saturday mornings. When Emma sneak up behind her, lift her overhead. The house was empty without it. But I still hear it. Every single day. It's mine now. And I guess that's the point. Life is one long series of partings. But no one ever really leaves. We move on, knowing we carry them with us. Pearl is with me now. I will love her for as long as I love anything. But for the first time in a long time, I feel unburdened, free. Like I don't have to run from the future. I have to let her go. But I'll never leave her behind. Because none of us are alone.